this is going to be a Let's Play Thief Deadly Shadows. My name is Lita and this will be a zero damage, one damage dealt and all the loot walkthrough. I hope that you will enjoy it and I'm not going to talk a long time now. I'm just going to click a button and to start a new game.
I got a tip last night from my fence, Heartless Perry. A nobleman named Lord Julian had some sort of quarrel and showed up at a local inn well after nightfall and in a foul mood. He's carrying a velvet bag about the size of a man's fist and it never leaves his sight. Sounds likely to be valuable, but I'll know for sure when I steal it from him. Perry sent over a floor plan of the place, the Blue Heron Inn. Finding his lordship won't be hard. His room number will be in the guest register, if I can get to the front desk to read it. The inn will have guards, but not as many as a private estate. That should make things easy, which is one of the reasons I'm willing to try it without knowing for sure what the take will be. Lord Julian is so protective of that bag. There's got to be something of value in it.
Yes, this is the start of the game. It's a training mission which you cannot actually skip, which is too bad because it's rather annoying. Stupidly designed, you are, for instance, forced to play in normal difficulty mode instead of being able to select the different modes here, which means that I only have to steal 40% of the loot in the mission. One special loot item, which is interesting, this must be the velvet bag, and the guards are pretty stupid, and Garrett has a whole load of damage resistance. The goals in a summary is break into the inn, find out what in which room Lord Julian is staying, steal his velvet bag and leave the inn. You actually only have to follow the glowing blue footprints in this mission because the mission is really designed for noobs. We have 10 water arrows. Water arrows are meant to shoot things like torches and stuff to put them out. We have a blackjack, which we will be forced to use in this mission. It's a non-lethal weapon used to knock out people when they are off and sleeping and unconscious for the rest of the mission. And a dagger, which is exciting, eh? This isn't a non-lethal weapon, it's used to stab people in the back. Oh, yeah. This is Garrett. Garrett has a mechanical eye. He has this eye because of the events of Thief 1. And, if I enjoy doing this here, then I may actually do a Thief 1 Let's Play in the future, I don't know yet. And this is only augmentation so far. This mechanical eye is used to zoom in onto stuff and to have a closer look. I don't know if I will use it actually all that much. You may notice that he looks different than in vanilla. This is because I'm using some texture replaces. For instance, he doesn't wear that ugly and horrible leather armor that he was wearing in the game as it was shipped. He's wearing this, which looks much more like what he's wearing in the cutscenes in Thief 1, to be honest. Also, some other changes are that the skins of guards and NPCs have a bit more sharpness to them. And if I have the mouse cursor over an object that I can interact with, then it's highlighted in brown instead of the original cyan sort of poisonous glow. Also, the loot gland is slightly different from vanilla. It's less in your face, you know. You'll see later on. It's far less obvious, which makes things a bit harder, I suppose. Garrett has no loot, Garrett has no items, but Garrett has a map. We start here at the X. obviously, there's a start button, then we follow the streets and enter by the cellar delivery hatch. Then we bypass the front desk, move up some stairs and find the peony seat suite, move on and we'll find the Lancaster room where the exit happens to be here. Yeah, enough talk. Let's start.